Hello, I'm Blake Ress, Commissioner of the Indiana High School Athletic Association. Today, I'd like to tell you about a friend to the more than 160,000 student-athletes in the state of Indiana, Farm Bureau Insurance. In their own low-key way, Farm Bureau Insurance has played a key role in the success of high school athletic programs throughout the state. Since joining the IHSAA as its exclusive corporate partner in 1988, Farm Bureau Insurance has contributed more than $3 million in support of high school student-athletes. On behalf of all the member schools of the IHSAA, we would like to take this opportunity to thank Farm Bureau Insurance for its support of our young people.
The South Bend Riley Wildcats and the Terre Haute South Rays face off in the Class 4A state title game. Both teams are led by outstanding juniors. The Wildcats are paced by Suntana Granderson. The number 3 Braves feature 6'6 Reicina Russell in the middle. Who will capture this year's Class 4A Indiana Girls Basketball Championship? The Indiana High School Athletic Association and Lacey Sports are proud to present the 2002 Girls State Basketball Championships.
The IHSAA Girls State Championships are sponsored in part by Roundup Ultramax, Methodist Sports Medicine Center, Indiana Members Credit Union, and St. Vincent Sports Medicine.
Greg, our PA announcer. Scott?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Indianapolis and Conseco Fieldhouse for the 27th Annual Indiana High School Athletic Association Girls State Basketball Finals. Our Class 4A championship game tonight features the Terre Haute South Braves and the South Bend Riley Wildcats. Here are your rosters and starting lineups for tonight's championship game. First for the Terre Haute South Braves. Number 15, Sarah Engel. Number 23, Laura Engel. Number 32, Megan Reisinger. Number 33, Jackie Gustafson. Number 34, Caitlin Bishop. Number 44, Joni Fisher. Number 45, Lauren Didden. And the starting lineup for the Braves of Terre Haute South at one guard, a 5'6" senior, number 22, Melanie Boeglin. At the other guard, a 5'6" senior, number 31, Kristen Clary. At forward, a 5'9" sophomore, number 25, Allison Terrell. At forward, a 5'6" senior, number 30, Darcy Rector. And the center, a 6'6" junior, number 50, Reicina Russell. And starting lineups for the South Bend Riley Wildcats. Number 12, Missy King. Number 20, Brittany Looney. Number 22, Jennifer Swanson. Number 23, Janae Gamage. Number 24, Myra Brazier. Number 33, Danielle Six. Number 34, Beatrice Pedraza. And the starting lineup for the Wildcats of South Bend Riley at one guard, a 6'1" junior, number 5, Crystal Norma. At the other guard, a 5'2" senior, number 11, Deanna Tops. And forward, 5'10" junior, number 35, Suntana Granderson. Forward, a 6-foot freshman, number 40, Kendra Reynolds. And the center, a 5'11" sophomore, number 44, Marcy Hack. Head coach of the 24-3 Wildcats, Mike Metchesey.
The stage is set. The final game of the day. The Riley Wildcats of South Bend and the number 3 ranked Terre Haute South Braves. Awesome talent on both sides. And Steph, again, some young players who've really proven themselves through the season.
That's right, a lot of young players that have been stepping up and playing very well. But this is what we've been waiting for, an exciting matchup tonight between Reicina Russell and Suntana Granderson. We're going to see two great players go at it right now. Looks like they're ready for a defensive tip.
And Norman wins the tip.
Wow.
She gets it herself and misses on the lay-in attempt. The rebound to Russell. Reicina Russell. The coach was asked the other day what colleges are looking at her. And Coach Morawski said, can you name one? Everybody is looking at number 50, and you should be too. She is exciting. Riley with some great depth. And some young players as well. Against the glass and a quick two for Allison Terrell, the sophomore.
Speaking of Reicina Russell, 19 points, almost 11 rebounds average, and you can't teach 6'6".
No, you can't. Beglin, a great steal. On the other end, the shot missed by Clary, and Terre Haute South has the ball back.
Two great teams going to battle it out right now.
Terrell going up against Norman, kicks it back out. This is Clary. Now to Beglin. Across the lane, in some traffic, and Rector loses the ball out of bounds, but last touch by South Bend Riley.
Terre Haute South being very aggressive from the get-go, taking it to the basket.
Well, Alan Morawski is the head coach of Terre Haute South, feels he has a solid all-around team.
Oh, yeah, this... We feel like we have a nice blend. Our two big ones, the point guard, Melanie Boeglin, and Reicina Russell, 6'6 post player. They score half our points, but yet we average 72 points a game, and this is a total team concept.
Head coach Alan Morawski talking about his team, and really with the exception of the center and point guard position, this Riley team is actually a little bit bigger.
Yeah, Riley has depth, and they have height at every position.
Terrell in traffic, and a personal foul. Well, South Bend Riley Wildcats head coach Mike Medjusi talked about today's matchup.
They're big. 6'6 and 6'2 across the front line, and Russell and Bishop, that's going to be a formidable task. If we were able to maintain position on the boards, hopefully we'll have a shot. The thing is, we're not intimidated by anyone. Our young players have stepped in and really gone after whoever we've gone up against. And our older players have maintained their poise and composure throughout the entire state tournament, and I'm very proud of them.
Well, already, Steph, we're seeing some great matchup play down low. Suntana Granderson rejected by Russell.
That's right. Suntana Granderson taking the ball to the basket strong, but Russell right there with the block.
Reynolds has it blocked away. Russell, another rejection.
I like to see these Wildcats, though, take the ball to Russell. They're not fading away. They're not altering their shot. It's better to get yourself blocked than to throw up something that doesn't have a chance.
Rector on the miss. Norman. Crystal Norman, very smooth, although losing that one out of bounds to Terre Haute South. Terre Haute South, a three-guard offense, knocked off the defending 4A champ Ben Davis last week in semi-state action. The three, nope, and the rebound comes down to Granderson. Granderson pulls up, jump shot, rims. Rebound to Russell. Quickly ahead, Rector, it won't go. Rebound, putback attempt, short. Russell finishes.
You can see one of the keys to the game for Terre Haute South was attack the basket, create foul opportunities or get easy layups, and they've been doing that right from the beginning of this ball game.
Reynolds misses. Reynolds, a freshman, 14 years old. Kendra Reynolds is going to be a great ball player someday.
Yes, she is. Reicina Russell right there already has her fourth rebound of the game. She didn't even have to jump.
Flat-footed. Russell receives the pass and drops it in. You know, 6-0 lead.
That's just something that Riley's going to have to deal with because she's there, and they're going to have to try to find any way they can. The biggest thing I think that Riley can do is try to push her out of the post. Don't let her get it in the low post. Make her shoot the 12 to 15 foot jump shot, and if she beats you from there, she deserves it.
Mike Medjese said exactly that, Steph. You've got to push that big player out of the middle if you're going to be effective tonight against Terre Haute South. Here's Mike Medjese. Graves with some full court pressure.
Norman gonna bring it down herself.
Granderson.
Nice pass.
And another block. This time Patton shot denied.
Terre Haute South really pushing the ball, and they're just, wow, it's gonna be a fast-paced game. We're gonna see another one.
It's gonna be a war. And Tara looks hurt. She came up holding her elbow. Now the jump shot is up and good, and 2 points for Granderson.
Nice move right there by Granderson. 20 points per game, almost 8 rebounds, 3 steals, 2.5 assists, and you can see right there she does it on the defensive end as well as the offensive end.
Wow, we're just underway in this game already in high gear. Riley, a winner in semi-state against Fort Wayne Northrop, and they've got quite a job tonight. We'll be back in a moment here on the Lassie and IHSAA Girls State Finals Network. All right, we are back. Terre Haute South leading by a couple of points. And this fan support for Riley has been incredible this season, and they have come to Indianapolis to hopefully cheer on their team one last time.
That's right. Both teams have great crowds, great fan support here at this tournament. Reicina Russell gets the ball. There she is already. 3 blocks, 4 rebounds, and 2-2 field goal shooting so far this game.
Now, Russell is big. Now, let's face it. She scores 20 points a game. She blocks everything in view. But she just looks like a player, doesn't she?
She does look like a ball player. And like we said, you can't teach 6'6". And right now, she's able to do basically anything she wants inside the lane. And she's going to be a tremendous player. She already is a tremendous player, but she's just going to keep getting better and better, especially as she gets stronger and more physical.
Open for the three. Clary can't get it to drop. Rebound fought for underneath. And into the ball game is Melissa King, who comes up with the rebound. And King, an outstanding softball player for this Riley High School team, and playing a great role here this season in a leadership position. And a whistle underneath. So that whistle stops the clock with 3:32 left to go here in the first period.
Right here you see Granderson taking the shot, an offensive rebound and a putback. Both teams is going to be rebounding is going to be very critical.
Marcy Patton at the free throw line misses in the first attempt.
I think we're probably going to see free throws being the key as well.
Kaitlyn Bishop into the ball game. And Jackie Gustafson in as well, wearing 33 for Terre Haute South. Patton's next free throw, no good. Norman fights for the offensive rebound, and then loses it out of bounds. So it remains 6-4. Braves on top by a couple.
Deanna Tapp's going to put a lot of pressure on the ball handler, bringing her down the full court, making her handle the ball.
Russell fouled underneath.
You know, all they have to do, Terre Haute South, come down the floor and throw it up. Reicina Russell's going to go get it.
Well, Riley so far has not been able to push her out at all. And this is kind of a hard, I would think, pretty hard scenario to try to duplicate in practice, step to guard against a player like Russell, who connects on a first
Most definitely. It's got to be a tough situation to do that. You just ask one of the guys, players, to come in and be the 6'6 Russell.
Offensive rebound, that's big. A swat
nice
by
block.
Norman.
Nice block by Norman. Come over and help out.
Granderson on the fly across the timeline. Toss will set it up. You'll not see a lot of offense from Diona Toss. However, she's a great point guard. Turnaround jump shot, no good. And it belongs to Riley. There's head coach Alan Morawska, who says this team plays 84 feet every time they go out. Crystal Norman with two more. Norman averaging 17 a game. Wildcats trail by one.
There you see Riley going to a 2-3 zone to try to get Reicina Russell out of the box, and right there that happens. You get her out of there into the short corner, taking baseline jumpers. You'd much rather take your chances with her shooting from there than shooting from the paint.
Granderson had a step on her opponent. She connects, and she'll go to the line.
That was a great shot by Granderson. She got the ball out in transition right here. Takes it up strong, hangs in the air, and finishes that shot.
Suntana Granderson. Granderson and Riley now on top by a couple.
Back into this 2-3 zone. I think they're going to use this and try to push Russell out, keep her out of the lane.
Granderson, pressure, turnover.
Good defense right there by Granderson.
Gustafson losing the ball, and Terre Haute gives it back to Riley with 2:24 left to go here in the period. That's a bit of an obvious kick.
I think that that Jackie Gustafson realized that she had a mismatch in the post, so she didn't want to let her get the ball. Oh, they called a foul.
I believe that's Gustafson's second. Two real quick fouls, and the reserve will, well, sit a little bit more. King triggers in. Norman.
Nice pass.
Block. Patton has it denied. Ahead comes South. And Darcy Rector's shot won't drop.
South continuing to push the ball.
Granderson.
Granderson continuing to take the ball to the basket, too, right at Reicina Russell.
Right at her. Boeglin. Met by Topps.
Nice
down
pass
to Russell, two more. Reicina now with three field goals, a free throw in two attempts, and seven first period points.
She does a great job of keeping the ball high. She doesn't put it on the ground while the guards can come in and get a hand on it. She gets the ball and she puts it up to the basket.
That is good to hear when you realize that a lot of young players are watching right now, and many of them truly idolizing these players in these championship games. But that's a great point. As a post position player, you can't afford to bring the ball down low.
You can, especially when you're 6'6". That's a long way to go to bounce the ball. And you got a whole bunch of little guards that can come in there and strip it at any time. But she does a great job. And I'm very impressed with how mobile she is. Very smooth when she gets the ball, going to the basket, even taking the 12-foot jump shot. Very mobile.
Laura Engel into the ball game for Terre Haute South. Russell gets it back and kicks it right back out to Boeglin. Boeglin missed some games early this season with a bone chip. Russell two more. And Reicina Russell has all but two of the points scored by South so far. Braves 11, Wildcats 9.
You go to what works, and when you can throw it up to 6-6, that's what you do. Riley doing a good job right now of taking their time. Nice shot.
Norman, Crystal, a quick Norman. Spin to the basket. Well, Norman and Granderson, they sometimes are deceptive in the way they move toward the basket.
Yes,
good hands
look
by
out,
Norman. Crystal Norman to steal. And now a turnover. 2-on-1 Braves.
Travel.
And a travel called. Boeglin had a step.
She did have a step. She didn't get quite a clear handle on the ball to go straight up into that layup, but took an extra step and got a travel call.
We're tied at 11. Seconds remaining in the period, and Norman spots up and nails the three. I mean, she nailed it.
We're going to take it that last shot. She was open, so she took it.
And so many coaches will tell you, if you've got the shot, take it.
Exactly.
If you're Crystal Norman, take it again. And Boeglin thought she had the shot. And what that does, it gives it right back to the Wildcats, and they've got some time here. 5.8 left in the period.
They do have some time right now. And you see a little 2-2-1. Terre Haute South has always been known for their 2-2-1.
Norman, Granderson lets it fly and off the mark. As the first period comes to a close, and these Riley fans excited about the way the Wildcats have played here in the first period. They got down early, but they've come back nicely on top by three. We'll be back in a moment. You're watching the 4A girls final right here on Lassie in the IHSAA girls state final network. They are the Wildcats, the mighty, mighty Wildcats. And South Bend Riley on top by 3 points as we transition into the second period here from Conseco Fieldhouse. Craig Wallen, Steph White-McCarty, and Steph, we talk about spurts. And the spurts are just all over the place here today.
It is. 10-4 run to end that quarter by South Bend Riley. And there have been two ties and three lead changes already in this game. So it is going to continue to be a game of spurts.
Rector finds Engel. And Laura Engel spots up nicely for the two-point field goal.
Nice shot right there by Engel. Terre Haute South needed a bucket. And they got it.
Granderson, nicer way to the basket. Comes up short. And South has it back, trailing by a point.
Engel again.
A miss. King fights for it and lost it out of bounds. Or did she? No, he said last touch by South. Tops with the ball. And some light backcourt pressure by Terre Haute.
Both teams right now doing a good job of attacking the basket.
Some great defense. Oh my. It was a nice job by Boeglin to begin what we thought was going to be another turnover, and then South loses it out of bounds.
Bishop couldn't hang on to it. Oh, you can't pass it through Reicina Russell.
Well, Steph, you played against some tall players in your day in high school basketball, but nothing like Reicina Russell.
Oh, nothing like Reicina Russell in high school. I think the tallest player I played against in high school is probably 6'3", but never 6'6 in high school.
Of course, now with the Indiana Fever, you see a few of those players and taller.
A few of those and taller, much taller. Nice, nice look.
Norman having a wonderful first half.
Yeah.
With a jump pass inside and the foul against the Braves.
That was a great look by Norman. She penetrating into the basket. Reicina Russell had to help, so Marcy Patton was open and she found her.
Out of bounds again. Well, you see the Big Ten Conference banner along the floor here at Conseco Fieldhouse. Mike Medjusy looking on. This is a very busy place with the Big Ten Women's Championships and the Girls Finals all in the same weekend. And how can anyone do that? Well, we do it here in Indiana.
Good hustle.
And a jump ball.
Granderson trying to get a timeout called, but the jump ball came first. Yeah, we're talking about Crystal Norman, and she's just having a tremendous game. 4-7 shooting already, 3 rebounds and assists, not to mention the tremendous defensive effort she's given out there on the floor.
Substitution is Laura Engel sits.
Oh.
Russell playing the high post right now.
Terre Haute South really working the ball, trying to get a good shot. Nice take by Boeglin. Anytime you penetrate and kick, you're going to get wide open shots.
Recker misses. Tops finds Granderson.
Nice.
She's all alone. Count it. Suntana Granderson complimenting Norman nicely. She now has 7. Norman with a total of 9 points.
It was a great look by Tops. She got the ball and she just looked out in transition to hit Granderson.
Slashing move. Russell puts it back. Reicina Russell.
That was a nice move by Boeglin. Reicina Russell, she's going to get those rebounds all day. Nobody put a body on her. You're not going to get an over-the-back call unless you put a body on her.
And a personal foul against Terre Haute South.
Fouls on the Braves, number 22.
And the foul.
I'm
not sure who that was on exactly.
Boeglin's second foul, I think.
Into the lineup for South Bend Riley.
So Riley with the ball now. Danielle 6 in for the Wildcats. 6 receives the pass.
Nice.
Has it rejected. Another block by Russell. Missy King ties up Caitlin Bishop.
I'll tell you what, that was great penetration right there. But when you penetrate and Reicina Russell comes to you, that's when you need to learn to kick. Penetrate, draw the defense, kick out to the shooters. Russell's got 5 blocks right now, 6 rebounds, 5 of 7 shooting. So she's doing her job offensively and defensively.
Hey, we've got a lot of basketball left to play here.
Yes, we do.
Boy, Patton jumping up and down on the weak side. She was wide open for a moment. Granderson having some problems with the ball. Inside Norman, pump fake, and a foul against Russell. Great job by Norman going right up again against Russell.
That possession, South Bend Riley kept the ball on the right side of the floor the entire time. When you're playing against a defense like this with Reicina Russell in the middle, you got to be able to move the ball. Right here, Norman takes it up. She may have got a little foul right there, but she's getting 2 free throws. But you got to move the ball. You got to use both sides of the floor, inside, outside, if you want to make Reicina Russell move.
The Riley swim team, runners up in the state finals. And now the girls basketball team making a run at the 4A girls state championships. Wildcats on top by a couple. Russell's turnaround shot is good.
13 points already for Russell.
Norman having some problems and lost it out of bounds. Mike Medjusy a little upset right now as he watched the sidelines for Riley.
Mike Medjusy, younger brother of Tom Medjusy, whose Lake Central teams have been to the state finals before. I'm sure that Tom had some nice advice for him.
Much younger brother, he'll tell you.
Much younger brother, yeah. I just was talking to him and he said, hey, that's my little brother out there. I think he's pretty proud of him.
Yes, he is. Good ball movement by the Braves. Little bit too strong off the glass by Terre. And Terre Haute South has it back.
Terre.
The shot.
Very persistent. Terrell's very persistent. And you get Russell getting another rebound and put back. You're not going to stop her unless you put a body on her.
Granderson right around Russell. Had Russell Well, I was going to say in the air. I don't think quite in the air, but did a nice job of getting around her into the hoop for two more. And Russell with another basket.
You know, Reicina Russell's 6'6", but she's not very wide. She's really thin, and nobody's playing physical with her. They're letting her go wherever she wants. Nobody's jamming her in on her cuts. Nobody's bumping her. Nobody's boxing her out. I think you have to try to get physical with her. She's not missing her shots. She's very efficient from the field, and you have to try to take her out of her game in some other way.
Substitutions ready to check in for both teams, but we'll take a break. Be back in a moment. Terre Haute South on top by a couple. You're watching 4A Girls Basketball here on the sea in the IHSAA Girls State Finals Network. 3:48 remaining in the first half. Riley trailing South Bend or Terre Haute South by a couple of points. Visit Dugan Chevrolet Pontiac at their new facility at Prestwick Crossing in Avon. Over 200 new units and 100 used units available. A modern facility with the latest technology to take care of your needs. Dugan Chevrolet Pontiac in Avon. Call 745-6444. Back to action.
Nice pass. Terre Haute South still doing a very good job of moving the ball from one side of the floor to the other. Double teaming Reicina Russell right now. Just got to keep her from getting the ball. Keep your hands up and keep her from touching the ball.
Running her nicely. In traffic. She gets the shot away. She misses, but right there is Terrell to put it in.
Melanie Terrell right there for the rebound and the putback.
And another steal. Clary comes up with it.
Clary, Kristen Clary, played number two singles for the state champion, 2001 state champion tennis team. So she knows what it's like to play for the state championship.
And that finesse that's required for tennis has to help here.
Oh, sure does.
Russell with two more.
Russell with 19 points already in this ballgame. Coach Medici has to think of something to try to contain Reicina Russell.
I'll tell you what, you've got Russell on one hand, and then the lunging defense by the Braves on the other, creating the offense.
That's right, they are. They're doing a great job of contesting everything. They're out all over the floor, hands moving, deflections. You don't always have to get steals, but deflections create a lot of havoc.
Tops back into the ball game, replacing six. And Norman to the free throw line for the Wildcats of South Bend. And Clary does a great job taking out the free throw shooter, getting the rebound.
They're just throwing it up there regardless of where she is.
And even though you know it's coming, it's hard to defend.
It is.
To say.
It's very hard to defend. All you can do is try to create as much havoc as possible. You know, a lot of what will help keep Reicina Russell from getting the ball is ball pressure on the passer. They're having all day to just stand there and look into her. And you can throw it up and she can go get it all day long. But if somebody makes the passer think about it, get in their face, make that pass a little bit harder, then you might keep her from getting the ball.
Russell goes up for it and walks with the ball. The turnover gives the ball back to South Bend Riley. With 2:30 to go here in the first half. And a backcourt whistle.
Terre Haute South playing this 2-2-1. I think they want to slow down the transition game of South Bend Riley. Riley, that's one of their keys, to create transition points.
Darcy Rector picks up her second personal for Terre Haute South. Team foul number nine, so to the line goes Missy King. Granderson.
Nice rebound by Granderson.
Missed. Rebound to Terrell.
Terrell has been a force on the boards offensively and defensively. Been very aggressive.
Oh, you gotta love the intensity. Fun to watch.
Yes, it is. Terre Haute South, with the exception of Reicina Russell, not really shooting the ball very well. 3 of 17, but Russell is 9 for 12, so she's making up for a lot of that lack of field goal percentage.
Russell has scored all but six of the South points so far, and she'll go to the line to shoot a couple.
Two shots.
Only a junior.
great future still ahead of her.
Sky's the limit.
Yes, it is.
Larry exits. So Russell, 2 of 4 from the line. Now with 20 points. And Riley has the ball, trailing now by 7.
2-2-1. Terre Haute South really covers a lot of ground in this 2-2-1 press. Normally it's meant to slow a team down. And right here, create turnovers.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Terre Haute has applied enormous pressure so far through this first half.
Yes, she has. Right now, it is the biggest lead of the game. 7 points, Terre Haute South. 7-0 run.
Russell bangs it against the board. Norman had the rebound, and then back into the hands of Terre.
Ball movement, moving the ball from one side of the floor to the other. Not just one wing to the other wing, baseline to baseline.
Allison Terre, we've spoken so much, Steph, about the strength of these players and how every year they get stronger and stronger. Terrell's strength right there made the difference.
It really did. She's going out and she's playing very, very aggressive offensively and defensively.
Marcy Patton hammered as she heads to the hoop. Patton will go to the line and shoot a couple.
Right here you see Patton taking the ball strong to the basket. Right around Reicina Russell getting her second foul. Seth and Riley having a lot of opportunities at the free throw line that are lost. They're not hitting them, and free throw shooting is key. That wins and loses the ball game. You're getting free chances at the basket. You got to be able to hit them.
2 of 7 so far for Riley from the charity stripe. Reicina Russell now sitting down with 127. She may remain there with 2 personals.
Riley now 3 of 9 from the free throw line.
And here come the Braves on top by 8.
The South Braves very disciplined offensively and defensively. They're continually moving on both ends of the court.
Henderson is out. Caitlin Bishop is in. Make that Russell sitting on the bench, and Bishop with the 2 points. And another personal foul in the backcourt.
You know, a lot of teams that play a 2-2-1 play it kind of relaxed and laid back. They want to cause the other team just to kind of slow down their offense a little bit. Terre Haute South gets after it. Even the 2-2-1, they're covering people and they're getting out there in the passing lanes, and they want to create as much havoc as they possibly can in the backcourt.
Crystal Norman at the free throw line. Norman having a good first half. 9 first period points for Mike Medjusy. Cool, calm demeanor for Norman. And the junior connects on both free throws. Now a 30-22 contest with the Braves on top by 8.
Southman Riley staying in this 2-3 zone. I think the goal of the zone is to make Terre Haute South shoot from the outside, but it's very spread out, and South does a good job of moving the ball and still getting shots in the lane.
Rector fires across the way.
See, the Braves have ample opportunity to shoot a 3-point shot, but they're very disciplined. Coach Moroska's done a very good job of getting this team to understand what you can do to win ball games. To understanding the importance of being patient.
Inside, turnaround jump shot off the mark for Terre. Put back, no good. King comes down with it. And a timeout. And I believe we'll keep it right here. South Bend Riley wants to talk things over with 14 seconds left to go in the first half. Bob Nagel will have our halftime entertainment for you, and it truly has been entertainment all weekend long here at Conseco, and especially here tonight for the girls' state finals, and some wonderful features along with our highlights coming up, stats and more, all at halftime.
This game certainly isn't disappointing, just as the previous games have been. Great teams hashing it out, and you continue to see the level of play in girls basketball rise, and these two teams are just perfect examples of that. From top to bottom, everybody plays their role, everybody goes out every single day and plays hard, and everybody wants to win, and you see them laying all out on the floor here tonight.
And college teams more and more coming to Indiana for their prospects.
That's right, they certainly are. Indiana has such tradition in basketball, and it just continues to get better.
Granderson a bit short. The rebound down to the Braves, 2 seconds, one.
Oh.
Offensive foul.
That's third foul on Boeglin. I think right there, you gotta understand time and clock, time and clock. Pull up and take that jumper or kick the ball off, but you can't afford to get your third foul with 0.2 seconds left before halftime.
Wow, that could hurt. That could really impact the second half, and we'll have to wait to find out how much it impacts the second half. Boeglin with three. Russell set about a minute and a half to conclude the first half. But Reicina Russell, a huge player in more ways than one here in the first half for the Terre Haute South Braves. Let's go now to Bob Nagel. Robert.
I'm Russell here today. Well, we just need to do a better job of denying her the basketball. They're getting it to her when we're in front of her and when we're behind her. It's been very difficult so far. We also have to prevent her from getting the second chance points because she's gotten some of her own offensive rebounds and putting them back in. We're going to talk about boxing out a little bit better at halftime, putting a little bit more pressure on their guards so they can't get that pass in so easily.
Good luck to you in second half.
Thank you very much.
All right, Mike Majesty, the head coach of the Riley Wildcats, and Craig Wong, we're half away. Foul trouble might be an issue in this one before it's over.
Yeah, we talked a little bit about that, and Steph, everything Coach Majesty is talking about is something that you've already mentioned, and it just goes to prove that we've got someone pretty special here that knows a lot about this game. Terre Haute South on top, back in a moment. You're watching the Lacey and IHSAA Girls State Finals. Well, head coach Mike Majesty said his South Bend Riley team expected controlled chaos here tonight. And it has been exactly that. South with a halftime lead, 30-22. And, boy, fast-paced
today's
action.
Halftime.
Steph in the first half. Outstanding action from Conseco Fieldhouse. We'll take a look at some of the highlights here along with the stats.
You see Reicina Russell making her presence felt early. She had five block shots in that first half and also on the offensive end doing a great job. But both teams just doing a tremendous job offensively, tremendous job defensively. The key for South Bend Riley, you have to stop Russell.
And it hasn't been an easy chore at all for Riley.
No, it hasn't. There you see her on the offensive boards. But on the flip side of that, Crystal Norman has done a tremendous job, as well as Suntana Granderson for Riley, taking them to the basket, just really keying their runs. And like we said before, basketball is a game of spurts. It's going to go back and forth the entire night.
Russell outstanding, 20 points of the 30 scored by the South team. And there you see the field goal percentages, Steph, and they favor the Braves, as you might expect with that low post play of Russell.
That's right, 23 rebounds to 19 for South Bend Riley.
All right, Bob Nagel with more from the floor here at Conseco Fieldhouse. Robert?
With Coach Ellen Moraska. And Coach, you got it going in the first half. Your big players playing very well, and your kids are really getting to the ball well.
Well, we're still pretty nervous. I'm disappointed in that. We got to do a better job of ball reversal, then get it inside or hit the outside shots after the ball reversal. Nerves. We're capable of playing much better than this, but a lot of teams come here and don't play this well. So we're just happy to be here and hope we can play this next half of basketball smartly.
All right, Coach, good luck. Thank you. Alan Moraska, back to you, Craig Wallen.
I don't know, Steph. I don't see many nerves out there. Coach seems to think so. We'll be back in a moment. Stay tuned. You're watching 4A Championship Basketball on the Lacey and IHSAA Girls State Finals Network. South with that 8-point lead. Visit Dugan Chevrolet Pontiac at their new facility at Presswick Crossing in Avon. Over 200 new units, 100 used units, all available. A modern facility with the latest technology to take care of your needs. Dugan Chevrolet Pontiac in Avon. Call 745-6444. We begin the second half. Russell throws it into Press Row.
You heard Coach Morosky talking about wanting to continue to reverse the ball and get the shots and ball movement, or lack thereof. I thought they had tremendous ball movement in the first half, and you see that he wants more, and that's just the type of coach that he is. He's very disciplined, wants his team to be very disciplined, and wants them to play their best every single night.
Open, Norman. A three-pointer. Now with 15 points, Crystal Norman having a great night so far.
Nice shot for Norman. South came out in a zone, which we didn't see them play very much in the first half, and Norman capitalizes on that three-point shot.
And back defensively, Norman fronting Russell.
Fronting and just keeping that one hand up. All you have to do is contest. Just keep that one hand up. You got to have somebody in front and somebody behind.
Five-point Braves lead.
You heard Coach Majesty talk about when he went into the locker room that you have to pressure the passer, and that's something that Riley's going to have to do, and you're not seeing a lot of it now, and just having one hand up doesn't really do it. You have to keep your hands moving so they cannot see Reicina Russell.
Excellent three-point shot by Darcy Rector.
Great shot right there. When you have good ball movement, you're going to get great shots, and Rector nailed that one.
The Braves' first tray of the night. Granderson pulls up, tries to get it over Russell, partially deflected. And another player down on the floor.
Carol's taking a beating today.
Well, she is. Now it looks like she might have banged up her elbow. Here comes Norman on the South turnover. Crystal pulls up, her three, too strong. Granderson fouled. And we just saw Allison Terrell banged up a bit. She comes back on the other end and commits the foul.
Fouls on the Braves, number 25.
Norman came down and pulled up for a three-point shot right here. And Granderson right there to get the offensive rebound. Does a great job of tipping the ball until she can get the rebound and takes it up and gets the foul.
And Terrell leaves the ball game as Granderson steps to the line. Now with 10 points.
Suntana Granderson at the free throw line. 34, Caitlin Bishop.
Well, I thought it was an elbow, but by the looks of it, it could be a wrist for Allison Terrell. Granderson gets both free throws to drop. And patience, a very, very big part of Riley's success all through the season. It's going to have to be big here.
Oh, it surely is. Push in the back. Push in the back right there by Kendra Reynolds.
Reynolds has been huge, both in regional and semi-state play. And so far, scoreless here tonight in the final step.
Scoreless here tonight, I think maybe a little bit of nerves coming in here as a freshman. But you can definitely see that she's a tremendous player and gets that get that foul call right there. But you can afford to get a couple of fouls just to keep Reicina Russell from getting the ball. South doing a good job of moving the ball. You got to continue to go inside out. Penetrate and kick against that zone, and you're going to get good shots.
Good look for Bishop. And the miss. Rebound to the smallest player on the floor, Diana Tops. Norman.
Oh, nice move.
Man, I'll tell you what. Norman had to make a move like that to get around Russell. A conventional layup wouldn't have worked.
No, it wouldn't have. That was a great move right there.
Great improvising. Mike Medjusy with a big smile on his face. And a backcourt foul against Tops.
Number 11, Deanna Tops, her second.
Deanna commits her second, and the team second here in the second half. Braves on top by four.
Backside's going to be wide open. Anytime you're playing that zone, you have to flatten it out for Reicina Russell. You're going to have the weak side open. Terre Haute South is doing a good job moving the ball, but right here, the ball's on the wing or on the top. If you penetrate, draw two defenders, you're going to have wide open shots, just like that. Ball movement right there.
From the corner, jump shot, no good. Rebound comes down to Reynolds. I think Riley doing a little bit better job fronting Russell here in the second half. And those are part of the adjustments that teams make, certainly at halftime.
That's right. Definitely doing a better job. They're getting somebody in front with their hands up, somebody in back with their hands up. So all you can see are Reicina Russell's arms. If she can't see the ball, it's going to be a lot harder for her to catch it.
Bishop commits the personal. And that sends Suntana Granderson to the free throw line.
Granderson a little bit quiet in the first half. I think she's going to become a lot more aggressive in this second half and make her presence felt. A little frustrated with herself right now after missing that free throw, missing a few shots in the first half, but you got to put that behind you and play this game. She's a tremendous player.
Great competitor. Granderson, only a junior, and connects on that free throw. So it becomes a 33-30 ball game with Terre Haute South on top by three. Boeglin dishes off. Rutger had an open look, decided against
nice
it.
Nice flash. That's flashed a great
across
flash.
You bet. Rutger gets the rebound. Kicks it out. Baglin's three. Count it. Melanie Boeglin with a three.
Melanie Boeglin averages almost 14 points a game. Those are her first 3 points for this matchup.
Reynolds shot. Like that Patton shot is off the mark. And here again come the Braves. And there's Russell from the free throw line. Shot no good. Patton again the rebound. O'Reilly getting some good help on the boards. Patton contributing. Reynolds down there. Of course, Granderson and now Norman.
Nice. Oh, Norman's got the hot hand. She's going to continue to take that shot.
Granderson fighting Russell for the rebound, as was Patton. And a personal foul against the Wildcats. And they're going to give it to Granderson. Suntana commits the personal foul, and we'll take a timeout here from Conseco Fieldhouse. Terre Haute South on top. Back in a moment. You're watching girls 4A basketball here in Lacey in the IHSAA Girls State Finals Network. Reicina Russell, an excellent first half. She continues here in the second half, leading all scorers with 20 points.
20 points, 9 of 14 shooting, 10 rebounds, and 6 blocks. She's doing it all here today.
And Crystal Norman has really contributed for Riley, now with 17 points.
She has. Crystal Norman, 6 of 11 shooting, 4 rebounds, and has 2 key 3-point shots.
Braves by 6. The final game of the day here from Conseco Fieldhouse. We're glad you've tuned in. Great action so far.
It has been a full day of great basketball.
Boeglin kicks it out.
Great ball movement by Terre Haute South.
Rector from deep in the corner.
Rector for another three from that same spot. I think she likes that corner over there. Terre Haute South just does a great job of moving the ball and finding the open player. They're very patient on offense. They don't take bad shots. They understand that, hey, we got to work. We get a good shot, we take it.
Patton having some problems in the lane. And Russell fights for the ball and ties up Patton. Well, we heard Coach Alan Roska talking a little bit about his team and the way they played in the first half, and we were shaking our head listening to him talk, saying that his team really didn't play nearly what they were capable of playing. That's surprising, I guess, because we thought they played fairly well.
Yes, I thought they played great. And right there, you know, you see how disciplined this team is, and that's a credit to Coach Moronka. They're very disciplined, they understand what it takes, and they're executing their game plan perfectly.
Clary with the triple. And a 12-point lead now for Terre Haute South. We'll be back in a moment. A timeout on the floor. You're watching the girls 4A championships here in Lacey in the IHSAA Girls State Finals Network. Terre Haute South on top by 12 over South Bend Riley in the 4A Girls State Finals here from Indianapolis. And I'll tell you what, Steph, Terre Haute has really turned up the heat.
They have on a 9-0 run, all three-pointers, four in this quarter. Rector, who's hit two of those, was 0-for-5 shooting in the 0-for-5 shooting in the first half, and then hit 2 3-pointers in a row.
Something must have been said at halftime.
I think so. I think that in the first half, Terre Haute South really wasn't looking for that 3-point shot. They took it if it was there, but they weren't really looking for it. Now, if they're going to take it, and they're going to look for it as well, because they got great shooters.
Reynolds connects for the first time tonight. Kendra Reynolds. the 14-year-old phenom. She will be a tremendous player for this team down the stretch run for South Bend Riley in the next few years.
Yes, she will. She's off to a tremendous start in her freshman year, and to get to the state finals, she's going to be one of those that has to say, hey, I know what it takes, and I want to get back.
Bodies on the floor. Rector getting up slowly.
Rector, if this is on her, it'll be her third foul. Right here. See the turnover. Trying to lob it into Russell. Granderson gets the ball, and Rector's just right there. Didn't give her enough room.
Riley with a chance to make a move right now. And quickly to the basket they go. The miss, the rebound. Boeglin racing out of the path.
5'6", Melanie Boeglin gets that rebound and is very strong with it. Good hustle by Norman right there. Great job.
And a good heads up timeout. Crystal Norman has game.
Yes, she does.
But she's lost some more flesh on the floor. Let's take another look at it.
She sure has. She's great defense right here. Ball's coming into the post. She just gets a hand on it and then gets on the ball. Calls a timeout. Good play right there by Norman. Don't want to burn too many timeouts, though. They only have two left, and it's a 10-point game. So you don't really want to burn too many timeouts.
Terre Haute South coming in, as we said, ranked third in the state. 20th, according to USA Today. And some great fan support. The total in the house here in the second session, 9,161. It's been a huge day here at Conseco.
Yes, it has. Terre Haute South stays in this 2-2-1. Aggressive 2-2-1. They've been in the entire game, and it's definitely done its job so far.
Off balance for Reynolds. Russell comes up with it.
South Bend Riley won an over the back call, but you got to put a body on Russell. You're not going to get over the back call with someone who's 6'6 and can just reach over you unless you put your body on theirs.
Two more for Reicina Russell. I've got her for 22 right now. Granderson.
Nice shot.
Off balance. Gets it to drop. Suntana now 14 on the night.
That was a great shot right there. Soft touch.
And here she comes out of the path. Suntana, two more.
Gets a steal. Granderson averages 3.3 steals, and there's one right there that'll take it in for the layup and really kind of give South Bend Riley some momentum.
Braves by 8. Russell's turnaround drops in. Nice soft touch.
That is, she does
size.
Have a nice soft touch, and I love the way she just catches it, turns, and shoots. A lot of post players, especially with her size, will catch the ball and they'll second guess. They won't even turn around sometimes and face the basket, and every time she gets the ball, she faces the basket and puts it up.
Patton will inbound. 9 seconds.
Nice steal.
Boeglin.
Oh.
And Crystal Norman commits the foul.
That was a nice steal right there by Boeglin. She read that the entire way.
And a big play to make defensively with seconds left here in the period.
That's right, and coming down left-handed layup, knows that if there's going to be contact, it's on the right side. I don't think that, I think it was a clean block, but I think she got a little bit with the body.
Boeglin 3 points so far.
When you just see young players that are watching, you protect the ball with your body, go up with that left hand, you're either going to get the layup or get the foul. That's why it's important to develop that at a young age.
Boeglin now with 4. She's headed to Indiana State University following her career at Terre Haute South. Marcy Patton out of the ball game for Riley. And Boeglin connects again. Making it a 48-36 game with 3 seconds. 2. Norman fires off the mark to end the third period. Terre Haute South fans on their feet, and for good reason. Their team on top, 48-36. They appear we say they appear to be in the driver's seat, and we'll find out. We've got one period left to go here from Conseco. You're watching the 4A Girls Finals on La Cie in the IHSAA Girls State Finals Network. Back to beautiful Indianapolis, Craig Wallen and Steph White McCarty, and what a game we've seen here tonight. Hebron losing to North Vermilion in Class 1A action earlier today. Southwestern the winner, along with Fort Wayne Bishop Lures, and in that Lures game, check that, in that Shenandoah Southwestern game, Amanda Norris with 30 big points. And I think right now, Reicina Russell is going to make a run at 30. She has 24 for South.
She does. She has 24 and the most points in a 4A game, 28 by April Traylor in 1998. So we'll see if Reicina Russell gets that record.
Granderson. A nice move around Russell and fouled beneath the basket. Riley keeping the pressure against Russell.
That was a nice move by Russell, taking it to the basket. A little up and under move right there, getting Russell up in the air. Granderson takes it up strong.
Granderson to the free throw line. And can't get the first one to drop.
Granderson looks like she's falling out of her shot a little bit. She's already a little bit off balance when she's shooting that free throw.
Granderson averages 20. She has 15 so far. Norman leading the way in scoring for the Wildcats. So with a free throw, now a 48-37 ball game.
Granderson, one of those players who does a lot of everything. Scoring, rebounding, steals, assists.
26 for Russell. Granderson.
Nice.
35.
Great quickness to get back.
Granderson.
Yes, great quickness. Granderson has great body control. She can go in many awkward positions, but she's always under control, and she can always put it up there soft off the glass.
South looking for their big player, Russell, out of bounds to Riley. Crucial point in the ballgame right now for the Wildcats. And King has it stripped away. And Riley will get it back. Granderson 19, Norman 17 so far for Riley. Great balance, as we knew the Wildcats would have.
That's right. You see good defense right there by Clary. Oh, both teams, I mean, just really hustling and getting after the ball.
Now Russell scrapping for the ball.
The biggest thing that we've seen all day long is just both teams in every game hustling, getting on the floor for those balls, playing their hearts out.
A 30-second timeout. We'll keep it right here. And remind you that there's plenty more basketball coming your way soon from TV 40. And those of you watching WHMB, you can watch the boys basketball regional action from Hinkle Fieldhouse next Saturday from 1 until 4 in the championship match at 11 p.m. And we're talking about regional action from Hinkle Fieldhouse. That's Saturday, March 9th, right here on TV 40. Well, girls basketball has been the main topic today, and women's basketball in general, huge here at Conseco Fieldhouse with the Big Ten championships underway.
That's right, a lot of women's basketball going on this weekend. A lot of great basketball.
Granderson, the miss. Boy, Topps tried to fight for that rebound. A little bit outmatched, though, by Boeglin.
You see Terre Haute South pushing it in transition, but if they don't have it, they back it up and run it off. Look at the middle of the floor. Somebody needs to flash right in there. It's wide open. You see again, very disciplined team. They're going to keep the floor spread. They're going to work the clock until they get a good shot.
Great spacer. Boeglin.
Nice pass.
Pushes off.
28.
Two more for Russell.
She's tied that record. Oh, Clary, nice steal.
And these South fans are on their feet.
They sure are. And they have reason to be. The biggest lead of the ball game right now.
52-39 Braves. Granderson picks up her third, the team's fifth.
The discipline and poise of this Terre Haute South team, it's unbelievable to have, you know, players like this. A lot of senior leadership to come out, but they understand what they're trying to accomplish. They don't rush into things. They don't force the issue. They just play the game the way it's meant to be played.
We thought we might see 30 there. Russell to miss. Norman. What a nice gliding move to the hoop by Crystal Norman.
Nice move. Norman with 19 now. She's doing a phenomenal job.
Boeglin, a nice dish to the open Russell, who's fouled from behind.
I think Russell, a little bit upset with herself. She could have finished that one. She didn't get fouled too hard, but it was a great pass right there. Russell goes up strong, gets fouled by Norman.
Two shots.
Let's see if she can hit one or both of these to break this record.
Very impressive play.
There it is. Reicina Russell just passes April Traylor. Most points in a 4A game.
She's the real deal, isn't she?
And there's still 5:47 left.
Granderson clears for South Bend Riley. The missed shot. Braves. And a timeout. A timeout by Terre Haute South with 5:37 left to play here in the final game of the night. Braves on top 53-41 over the Wildcats of Riley.
Darcy Richter calling that timeout. She knew she was going to get trapped, wanted to have an opportunity to get it out of there, and decides to use one of their timeouts.
Mike Medjesi, what a job he has done. This Wildcats team sputtering over the last 5 years or so, but boy, they have gelled nicely, and they've got some real players out there.
Yes, they do, and he's done a tremendous job with them.
Well, March 16th, the Indiana High School Bowling State Finals. Well, everything's covered on TV 40. 2 o'clock live, and then the Hinkle Boys Semi-State, 4A and 2A, 10 p.m., all on March 16th. Busy time of the year.
It certainly is a busy time of the year. We got some stats on Reicina Russell, 13 of 19 shooting, 11 rebounds, 7 blocks, 29 points right now.
Oh! Gustafson feeding Boeglin, and the foul by Granderson.
Boeglin's one of those tough players, you know, when she goes down hard like that.
It was not an intentional foul.
Boeglin taking it up, getting hit in the head. I don't think it was intentional, but I think she got maybe an elbow in the head right there. So she, there you see Granderson right there, patting her on the back, letting her know, hey, I didn't mean to do it like that, but I think Boeglin's one of those tough kids.
Bone chip earlier in the year. Tough player. She missed a few games early on for the Braves. Banged up a couple times already here tonight. But keeps on moving forward. Boeglin, the two free throws. A 14-point lead now for Terre Haute South.
Terre Haute South has just been great on the defensive end there. They're offensively, we know that they can get the ball to Reicina Russell and she can convert, and they can convert offensively. But I've been very impressed with their defense, the way that they cover ground with this very athletic South Bend Riley team.
Riley extremely quick. We've not seen a lot from Reynolds, who tries to jump past it inside. Now Granderson's shot is short. And Rucker comes up with the rebound.
Boeglin bringing it down. Terre Haute South spreading the floor now. Just going to try to work some of this clock until you get a good shot. Great ball movement.
Boeglin might have taken that shot earlier in the game.
Yeah, she might have. It's just, you can just see the discipline right now in this Terre Haute South team. Nice pass.
Boeglin. Russell off her fingertips. And here comes Crystal Norman.
Oh, stepped out of bounds.
Turnover against Riley. Substitution. In the ball game comes Beatrice Pedraza for the Wildcats. Pedraza, only a freshman.
Coach Moses is getting Granderson a break so he can put her back in for this final run.
Boeglin goes to work against the freshman.
Nice pass. Great job. See, continuing to move the ball, work for the best shot on the floor, not just any shot, the best shot.
Big difference.
Yes, it is. Terre Haute South has been on a 22-11 run, starting by a three-pointer by Boeglin, and that was with 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Southman Raleigh's going to have to get out on him. See, that's one of those things that Boeglin does. She knows that in order to get the ball back out, to run some more time off the clock, you have to penetrate, draw all the defense to you, and then you can continue to move it.
Danielle Six commits the personal foul for Riley.
Has to go inside to come back outside.
Well, just real smart basketball tonight for Terre Haute South. They've made few mental mistakes and some substitutions. Pedraza will sit down. To the line goes Boeglin. And the senior has yet to miss from the free throw line in five attempts.
Boeglin's been great from the free throw line.
On the year, averaging close to 14 points.
We jinxed her.
Yeah, we did. I knew it as soon as I said it. Crystal Norman fighting Russell. Tips it into the hands of Gustafson.
Nice pass.
Richter, Miller, and Thomas comes up with it. A little less than 3.5 minutes to go. And Reynolds is tied up. The ball back into the hands of Terre Haute on the change of possession. We've got a break in the action. A 15-point Braves lead. Back in a moment. You're watching 4A girls basketball here on Lacey and the IHSAA Girls State Finals Network. Reicina Russell, 29 points so far for the Braves. Terre Haute South on top by a score of 56-41. And Stephanie White, how do you score 63 points in a game that goes by this quickly? You did that.
You have very good field goal percentage, field goal shooting percentage. Yeah, and if anyone's interested, the most points scored in any state girls championship game, 1980. Maria Stack, Columbus East, 42 points. Reicina Russell could be on track for that one, but I think Terre Haute South is going to be very disciplined in their half-court offense right now and work the clock and use it to their advantage.
Granderson goes up. Partially blocks that pass, and a whistle stops the clock once again. So the foul is on Thomas. It's her third personal. And Kristen Clary to the line for the Braves.
Important now for Terre Haute South to hit their free throws. Taffin Rye is going to foul, and they need to hit their free throws. Clary right now at the free throw line. 7 assists in this game for her.
Well, that's big.
That is huge. She averages 2.8 assists, 7 points, and 7 assists here tonight.
And it never fails, does it? You see a player like Clary who does something exceptional in a situation like this, something that during the regular season maybe she didn't accomplish that often.
That's right.
17-point lead for the Braves. Dishes off. The left-handed shot from the far corner by Moody, who's in there, misses.
Nice rebound by Granderson, giving her team another opportunity, taking a three-point shot.
A miss.
Russell with the rebound right there. 13 rebounds for Russell.
A solid double-double. Reicina a point away from 30 points. And her team with a cruise. You're on autopilot, I would think.
I think if I'm not mistaken, the record for rebounds in a game is 15. Kelly Kuhn, 1998 for Lake Central.
Boy, you remember everything.
I don't know about that. Dennis Casey here feeding me some stats.
The stats king. And another foul. This final few minutes here could go well into the night. And I believe that's on Tops, and that will be her fourth. So back to the line goes Melanie Boeglin.
Boeglin, a 73% free throw shooter, so she's been tough from there.
And gets it to drop. Boeglin now 7 of 8 from the charity stripe. And her Braves on top by a score of 60-41. Nice steal attempt. Norman regains. Reynolds misses. And another whistle underneath. 2:04 left to go.
I think you got Granderson over the back right there.
Well, Granderson has left it all out on the floor, as
has
Crystal Norman and the rest of this Riley team.
Granderson, 19 points, 7 rebounds. She's done a great job, just a junior. Terre Haute South, 12 of 16 from the free throw line, so they're doing a very good job free throw shooting, and that's going to be key the last 2 minutes of this ball game.
Gustafson to the line for the Braves. Jackie Gustafson off the bench is yet to score. Early on in the first half, it was all Russell, but here in the second half, some good balance by these Terre Haute South Braves. And the first point of the night for Gustafson.
I think if you're South Bend Riley, you're looking for who to foul. Darcy Rector is a 48% free throw shooter. Everybody else is 60 and 70%.
Russell now with 31. Norman gets it to go down and then back out. It rims, and the Braves have it back.
South Bend Riley having a hard time finding the basket right now. Terre Haute South on 11-0 run. They just can't seem to get anything to fall.
Braves exceptional here tonight, especially here in the second half.
That's right. And this is a Riley team with 4 seniors. But the majority of the people that played in this game tonight are underclassmen, so they could have a chance to be back.
1:20 left to go. Riley had a 3-point lead after the first period, and it was only an 8-point game at halftime. This second half, though, has been huge for the Braves, as you see Crystal Norman take a seat now for the Wildcats.
Crystal Norman did a great job.
Wholesale substitutions ready to check in for Terre Haute South.
That's right. These players that are on the floor right now deserving of this break they're getting, and I think that Coach Morosco wants to give them an opportunity to come off the floor to a standing ovation.
Boeglin calls the timeout on behalf of her team, and with 1:02 left to play, Terre Haute South going to make a wholesale change here, pulling all 5 off, and you'll see a new 5 in just a moment. Terre Haute South on top, 63-41. Back in a moment. You're watching girls 4A basketball right here in Lacey in the IHSAA Girls State Finals Network. Every picture tells a story, Steph.
Sure does. It sure does. You see Reicina Russell right there. Just found out 15 rebounds. She did tie the record. Kelly Kuhn from Lake Central, she tied it with 15 rebounds. Broke the scoring record for a single game in the state championship. Reicina Russell has had a great night.
Not bad at all. And Russell, one of the biggest cheerleaders right now. as five new players enter the ball game for Terre Haute South.
That's right. These players get a step on the floor and know what this feels like to be in this kind of situation, in this type of environment.
And Riley with some substitutions as well. And we'll try to get the names of all these players who are in right now. Mike Medjusy getting a lot of his players in, and players that we'll see next season as well.
That's right.
Her first, Kate Smith.
Brittany Moody back into the ball game. Ira Brazier is in. Her father, a huge boxer. I mean, Harold Brazier, one of the all-time great boxers in America. And then Myra Brazier, a 5'1" senior, into the ball game now for South Bend Riley. And a personal foul, and Janae Gamage to the free throw line for the Wildcats.
I think both teams can take a lot from this. Not only the players, you know, that were out there playing, but the players that were on the bench that didn't quite get as many minutes as well. You can take a lot from this game, and the biggest thing is nobody has given up. Any game that we've seen today, everybody's played till the final buzzer. And you can't rank heart and desire. We've talked about it all day long, and that's and this is an experience that will last forever. The memories will last forever.
The other direction, the miss. The putback attempt is no good. And the ball squirts out to Riley. Here come the Wildcats, and Moody is fouled on her way to the hoop. 18.9 left.
Moody does a good job chasing that ball down, taking it to the basket. She gets two free throws right here.
Moody should be back next year, the 5'7" junior, to the line for Riley. These Riley fans have not given up cheering for their team.
Well, and how about Alan Maraska? 20 years, 323-133 record, his first state championship. It's got to be a treat for him, and I'll bet these girls are very proud to have the opportunity to help his dream come true as well as their own.
That's wonderful. That is wonderful. Inside 10 seconds. Rhodes. And we have our fourth champion of the day. Terre Haute South, the Braves. A very impressive win over the Wildcats of South Bend Riley, who played very, very tough through the first couple of quarters, especially. The second half, though, belonged to the Braves. And boy, Reicina Russell, 31 points, 15 rebounds. That is hard to compete against.
It is very hard to compete against. She just did a great job. And the Terre Haute South team in general did a great job, very disciplined. Very unselfish. They played together. They knew what it took to be state champs, and they went out and executed their game plan. South Bend Riley played a tremendous game today as well. It's just it was Terre Haute South's night, and Riley actually didn't score from the 5:54 mark on until that last free throw. So they had a tough time finding the basket, but a lot of young players that are going to return for both of these teams.
Russell made a statement in the first half. And let's go now to the floor and Bob Nagel.
Coach, congratulations. What a great win. A lot of people helped out tonight. A great team effort.
Oh, it was a great team effort. And, you know, not just Lady Braves got a monkey off their back. This win is for all the players of Terre Haute, male and female, over the years, all the great coaches, late Willard Kurt, the late Don McDonald, Howard Sharp, Curly Holt, Pat Rady, Jim Jones, all of us. You know, there's been some great coaches, some great players in Terre Haute, and finally these kids got the monkey off their back. Hopefully the next one will come a little sooner for anybody.
Great job, Reicina Russell. Record-setting night tonight with rebounds. She tied the mark, set a scoring mark tonight. Again, there was more than her, but she was special tonight.
Oh, undoubtedly. You know, you come into a game like this, and I try to explain to the kids that, you know, you're so nervous, it's much better to start inside and work outside. And I think they finally believed me after that second half, because they finally relaxed. Reicina caused the outside to open up, and they knocked down some big shots, some big shots. Darcy Rector, she'd really give blood and shoot the ball. And you know, Tristan Clary hit a great shot from the out that just really helped bury him when we needed a run.
We had a great run. Melanie Boeglin with some great leadership as well. Made a lot of key free throws for you. Just, again, a total team effort is what you expect from your team to rise to this occasion.
Thank you very much. Melanie's just capable of playing brilliantly as she did in the regional, or we wouldn't have been here. And she's a great floor leader. I know she's probably hurt. My assistant coach wanted to check on her, and I said, no way. If she's walking and breathing, she's staying in the game. We're not taking her out unless she asks to come out.
All right, Coach. Well, hey, you have a great, safe trip back home and celebrate. Congratulations. Great
Thank
win.
Thank you very much. We're going to do that.
All right, Terre Haute South wins the state championship here at Conseco Fieldhouse. We'll take a break and come back with more of our postgame awards in just a moment. You're watching the IHSAA Indiana Girls State Championship Network.
The award celebration following the final game of the day here from Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. The 4A champion, Terre Haute South, and the Braves' key player this season, Darcy Rector, on the podium receiving the Mental Attitude Award. And what a great award. What a great player.
Yes, what a great player. Hit some key shots for this team. Has been the leader. You know, you can tell she's a leader on the court, but also this award shows that she's a leader in the community. She's a leader in the classroom.
Now these Braves certainly showed a lot of leadership here tonight. Terre Haute South improving to 25-2 to win the state championship. And now South Bend Riley receiving their runners-up awards. And Riley finishes with a remarkable 24-4 season. That is incredible, and what a run they had this year.
It is, and it's great, you know, for the school. They've had a lot of state championships in other sports, but to get here and be a state runner-up and girls basketball can show, you know, a lot of the younger players that are coming up through the system that, hey, we can do this year after year. We just have to establish our tradition. And Coach Majesty has done a great job with this team, and they have a great future ahead of them.
A lot of youth. Crystal Norman will be back. Suntana Granderson will be back. Kendra Reynolds, only a freshman, 14 years old. She has matured a lot through this process. She will be a huge impact player next season as well for South Bend Riley. They've got a lot to look forward to.
Yeah, they do. They certainly do. A lot of talent that's coming back. And nothing can replace this experience. You've been here. You've done it. You know what it takes. Next year, these younger players need to come in and say, hey, we want to be there again, and this time we want to win it.
Methodist Sports Medicine Center, in partnership with Clarion Health, provides sports medicine coverage for more than 20 high schools and is also the official sports medicine provider to IHSAA championship events, providing coverage for 11 colleges, including Butler, Indiana, Indiana State, Indianapolis, and Purdue. Methodist Sports Medicine Center is also the official sports medicine provider for the Colts. Medicine Sports Medicine Center. We keep you in the game. And a look there at Deonna Tupps, who kept this Riley team in the game more than one time. And Mike Medjesi receiving his medal here. The red ribbon. His team wanted the blue one. They get the red one, and I know they're very happy with their accomplishments.
Yes, they are. They certainly should be happy with the accomplishment. I mean, just getting here is a tremendous honor. We've talked all day long about how much of an honor it is to get here, and a lot of teams would love to be in this position right now. Bittersweet, I'm sure, but definitely understand what it takes to get here, and now they look forward to next year and build off of what they've accomplished this year.
Great administration, great staff, assistants, and Riley holding up their medals and their plaque as runners-up, the superintendent, South Bend Riley, Dr. Joan Raymond, the principal, George McCullough Jr., John Berta, the fine athletic director, great staff, all down through the years, they've given us so much support. We want to thank them here publicly and congratulate them on a great run here in 2002. Outstanding job, and this victory by Terre Haute South is the final victory of the day for the class basketball afternoon and evening that we've had. 1, 2, 3, and 4A. It's been a wonderful day. Great attendance figures. 91-61 here in the evening. And just under 9,000 in the first session.
Yeah, the attendance has been tremendous.
Darcy Richter.
And I don't think these fans really mind much who's out there playing. The entertainment here has been unmatchable. It has been great. And we have seen, I don't know, Steph, I don't remember seeing as much emotion and as much hard-nosed play as what we've seen out here today.
Oh, no, it definitely has. It, year after year, continues to get better, not only the talent level, but the emotion level and how much these players invest in the game. In the past, you see a lot of players that play just because they like to play ball, but they don't invest as much as the players nowadays do and think about a future in basketball and women's basketball, college basketball, but the emotion and the energy that they put in, you know, it just means so much more to them. It's not just a game of basketball anymore. It's a passion for most of these players. We got the total attendance for the day, 17,320, so quite a turnout for the day.
Lots of folks coming here, and you see a lot of kids who are looking up now to these champions in classes 1, 2, 3, and 4A. And they are role models, whether they realize it or not.
Yes, they are. A lot of kids who are practicing in their driveways, practicing at home right now, that want to be up on this podium and want to know what it feels like to win a state championship, and definitely looking up to these players here tonight.
The superintendent at Terre Haute South, Daniel Tanous, receiving his award, along with Principal James Fries, the athletic director, Deb Webster, Coach, of course, head coach Alan Morawska, and then his assistants Larry Stuckey, Aaron Bird, Chad Chrisman, Melissa Keegan, and the Braves finishing off a dream season for this coach who's been at it for 20 years here at Terre Haute South.
20 years, and he finally gets a state championship. Much deserving. Very much deserving. Alan Morawska. I think this team was proud to give it to him.
Indeed. And you know what? He told Bob Nagel earlier that it really comes down to more than just the present players and present coaches. It's a tradition at Terre Haute South that began a long time ago. A lot of effort, a lot of sacrifice, I'm sure, went into developing this program, and something that doesn't happen overnight.
That's for sure. It doesn't happen overnight. And I'm sure you can ask any of these players, and they were once fans in the stands watching some of his previous Terre Haute South teams, and they're just fortunate to be able to reap the benefits.
Don't go away. We've still got much more to come from Indianapolis and Conseco Fieldhouse. Back in a moment here at Lacey Broadcasting and the IHSAA Girls State Finals Network. Steph White-McCarty, Terre Haute South, finishing the night as champion, 63-42, the win over South Bend Riley. In just 3 weeks, join Lacey Broadcasting, TV 40 and TV 46 for the Boys State Basketball Championships. Live action begins at 10:30 Saturday morning, March 23rd. Back to the floor and Bob Nagel.
Well, Mike Majesty, the head coach of the Riley Wildcats, and coach, obviously know what's your plan coming down here, but kids never quit. You worked hard, but boy, you ran into a record-setting night tonight from Reicina Russell.
Oh, yeah, 6'6". She gets the ball 2 feet from the basket. She can shoot from 2 feet, I know that. I'm very proud of my kids. We battled hard. It was just a major accomplishment for all of Northern Indiana, especially South Bend, for us to just get here. You know, I'm very proud of the kids. I love them like they're my own daughters. They're already talking about coming back, and that's what I like to hear.
You had a great effort from Suntana, Granderson, and Crystal Norman, as you would expect. Didn't get much help this year, but I know you got some kids who are sitting on that bench looking out there and saying, I got to get better. I got to help this team next year.
Yeah, we're going to take a little bit of time off. Right after spring break, we'll get started again. My guess is they may want to start on Monday, but I'm going to make them take some time off. Again, you know, we're very proud. We're very excited. It's an experience of a lifetime, and I just hope we get to experience that lifetime next year.
Well, you may face this team again. They got a junior coming back. Good luck to you, and congratulations on a great season.
Thank you very much, Bob. I appreciate all your support this year.
All right, Mike Majesty from South Bend Riley, an outstanding effort, and again, a situation where Riley just had no answer for Reicina Russell. I'm not sure anybody's going to this level, maybe even at the next level. And I know, Stephanie, you've seen young talent come out of high school. I got a feeling there's a lot of coaches going to be looking at this tape tonight.
Oh, most definitely.
Can she play at a higher level? That's a rhetorical question, huh?
That's a rhetorical question, and everyone knows that answer. Of course she can play at a higher level, and it's going to be great to see her continue to get better.
And nothing wrong with those close shots from 2 feet out.
Not when you can get them.
And she can get them from outside as well. She is a complete player, and what a joy to watch. Reicina Russell, 29 points, leading Terre Haute South to the 63-42 win tonight over South Bend Riley. Back in a moment here on Lacey and the IHSAA Girls State Finals Network. 21 points in a winning cause for Terre Haute South. Let's go to the floor and Bob Nagel.
Well, great threesome here on the floor with me. First of all, Darcy Rector, mental attitude award winner, congratulations. I know you got great support from your mom and dad, all the teachers, everybody at Terre Haute South.
Yeah, we've had such great support from everybody this whole year. All the fans, we just want to thank everybody for backing us up the whole way. It's been a great year.
Well, you got a special award and you got a nice medal around there. Melanie Boeglin is here as well. Melanie, congratulations.
Oh, thank you very much.
This has got to be a dream come true for you.
Oh, it definitely is. Ever since my freshman year, we've wanted it, and to get it our senior year is just awesome.
Easy to get assists tonight when you throw the ball into Reicina Russell. Reicina, congratulations. A record-setting night, the most points scored in a four-year game. You tied the rebounding mark. You're really on your game tonight.
Well, everything I do is basically for the team, and I couldn't do it without the team. So anything that I did tonight, I'm giving all the respect that people are giving me and all the fame and everything to the team. I don't take any credit for anything.
If you do that, you're liable to win. You were liable to win championships with an attitude like that. Congratulations.
Thank you. I try. I love these girls. They're my
I don't blame you. What great leadership. Reicina Russell, Melanie Boeglin, and our Mental Attitude Award winner, again, Darcy Rector. Congratulations, ladies. Have a safe trip home. State champions in Class 4A. Craig Wallen, Stephanie.
Boy, you can't beat that. What a great finish to a wonderful day, Steph.
It has been a great finish. This day has been tremendous, a tremendous day of basketball for the whole state of Indiana.
1A, North Vermilion, the winner over Hebron. Southwestern, a winner, along with Fort Wayne, Bishop Lures in 3A, and of course Terre Haute South knocking off South Bend Riley here in the nightcap. Hey, we want to thank our producer, director, Jeff Elliott, our fine crew here tonight from Indianapolis. Steph, great working with you.
Great working with you, Craig.
Dave West, our director tonight, thank you for joining us right here at Lacey and the Indiana High School Athletic Association State Finals. Don't forget, boys coming up soon, so keep it right here. This is Craig Wallen. So long, everybody.